I thought it was amazing. I thought I'd never seen nothing like it, not even on TV.
Dog feces from one side of the home to the other.
It's terrible.
Stacks of garbage and empty dog food bags.
Like he just gave up.
Take a look at these pictures for me. Can you verify that those pictures are of inside this home?
Yes, ma'am. That's it. That's the living room. That's the kitchen. That's down the hallway.
What is that?
All that is animal feces and dog hair and trash.
And you've seen that personally?
I've walked right on top of it.
Kenneth Nelson says his girlfriend's family lives right next door to this home on Emerson Court. He says the owner invited him in to look at some furniture.
I saw liquor bottles, empty dog food cartons, containers, bags, some cobwebs hanging from the ceiling.
How long do you think this stuff has been there?
Like it's been going on for years.
One of the worst that I've been in a long time.
We contacted the city's neighborhood services department about these pictures. Inspectors told us they knew nothing about the home until we called. They agreed to meet us at the house and take a look inside.
Number of fixtures such as kitchen sink, bathroom, lavatory, toilet, and bathtub that were unsanitary.
Code enforcement officer Bruce Bailiff says a big health concern is the dog feces that could attract unwanted pests.
I was really surprised by the lack of flies in there.
How much of it was in the house?
It covered most of the floor.
On the whole house?
Just about the whole house.
Neighbors say they're concerned about the smell.
Smell like dog droppings and things like that. It's just a nasty odor.
The house has been turned over to a bank. We tried contacting its original owner.
Hi, is this Xavier?
He had no comment. Now, this house could be condemned, and if the problems aren't fixed within a certain time period, Bailiff tells us he can go right to city council and ask for an order of demolition. Wanda?
Oh, really hard to look at those pictures. You mentioned empty dog food bags and animal feces. Any indication that there are animals still living there now?
Yeah, there's a dog that lives in the back of the home in a caged-in area. Neighbors showed us that location. They say they've been feeding the dog daily, that the owner was there just yesterday, but they're not sure who's actually taking care of the animal.
All right, Nicole Ducouer reporting live tonight. Thanks a lot, Nicole. Well, the city of Winston-Salem has a program in place to deal with a situation like this. It's called Operation Impact, a partnership between local government and neighborhood organizations. Its mission is to improve neighborhoods by dealing effectively with nuisance properties. Now, to fall under Operation Impact, more than one city department has to be notified about a problem property or the owner. Also, the property or property owner must have a long-standing history of code violations, and the property must be considered a public safety hazard. Now, if you'd like to report a neighbor or property that falls under these categories, call the Winston-Salem Trash Busters hotline. That number is 734-1268.